Hi, it's James here. I'm gonna today show you a YouTube video, and this is gonna go viral, and Lionsgate's gonna be famous. It's on FESR, front-end speech recognition. So what are some of the benefits of front-end speech recognition? Let's rattle some off. It's plug and play, it's ready to use in minutes. Your profile follows you around to whichever workstation you use. There's instant conversion of our dictation into our medical reports. So what we say is instantly in the system after we sign our documents. We're able to suspend a document, even mid-dictation, for editing later. So no longer will you lose it when you hang up the phone. We can just go back to our partially dictated document and complete it. There's no delay in turnaround times, which eliminates the need for statistical reports. And finally, we have access to historical documents that we have dictated or others have dictated on the system. A lot of benefits here, a lot to think about. This is our standard mic here. It has the record button. Really, this is the only button you really need to know. Here is a little mouse ball, so it actually acts like a little mouse. And finally, there's a bunch of function keys here. You can map them to whatever you like. Some of what I like to do is I have a correct that function key, an undo that, and a insert normal physical exam. So without further ado, let me show you the screen here. So here's our typical Windows desktop screen. And today I'm just gonna fire up M-Modal Fluency Flex. And as you can see, I'm gonna spare you guys from looking at my password, but I fired up an instant of Fluency Flex over here in this window. Okay, so now I'm just gonna maximize this window. I have a patient that I need to search for, so I'll search for a patient. I have an MRN, I'll put in a very top secret MRN, don't tell anybody. And it'll fire up this very exciting test patient, Fesserly Testa, or Testa Fesserly. So I'll click on her. This is the visit associated with Testa today. This window here tells me that I have all these options. I could do a consultation, anesthetic record, diagnostic report, history and physical. Today I'm gonna pretend I'm like one of you esteemed colleagues and do a consultation on this patient. So I'll click on it. This fires up this window right away, right here. This is a blank slate. So if I want to dictate right now, into here, I could just dictate whatever I want freeform, like a blank Microsoft Word document. But what I'll do is I'll select a template that's being made, that I've made myself or that's being made for me. I click that button there, and then I come down here and then select the standard. And as you can see, the standard consists of a bunch of just basically titles. And these are fields that I can dictate into. So I'm gonna click on this field here, underneath the history of present illness. And then we'll dictate a little story. I'll say, this is a 57-year-old female who's been complaining of cough, comma, fever and chills for approximately 1 week period. She states that since she's been back from Southeast Asia on a chicken expedition period, she's not been feeling well period. She complains of night sweats, fever, and is short of breath with only mild exertion, comma. She can only walk across the room period. So let's say I got the age wrong. I would say select 57-year-old female, 47-year-old female. Good, and I just dictate over it and it corrects that phrase. Item one, amlodipine, 10 milligrams. Item two, ASA, 81 milligrams. Now, the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to insert a text snippet. So I've already created a text snippet previous to this with a normal respiratory exam. So I'm going to dictate insert normal respiratory exam and hopefully it'll pop up. Insert normal respiratory exam. Good. So as you can see here, it's inserted a template that I've created. Now, this patient does not have good air entry bilaterally with vesicular breath sounds. So I'm going to say select good air entry bilaterally. This patient has left lower lobe crackles and bronchial breath sounds, comma. She has extensive wheezing in bilateral lung zones, period. So there you go, I've corrected that. And I could get rid of with vesicular breath sounds. So I hope this short little demo helps to demystify some of the front-end speech recognition. Now, I can't say there's no learning curve. There is a short little learning curve, but once you get through that, it's pretty easy and it's pretty fun. So with that, I advise all you guys to get out there and give it a try.